welcome back to another installment of the Digilism After Hours. Tonight, we'll be reviewing the game known as House of Ashes. This came out recently during October, a couple weeks before Halloween, actually. This is a third installment to the franchise known as the Dark Picture Anthology. Now, this isn't the last game, because we earlier this week had a trailer released, and if you played through this entire game, you get that sneak peek before the trailer was even released that there is one last game. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about the actual game itself, House of Ashes. Now, I'll go ahead and say it. It is a horror title, which I don't believe it should be. I believe it should just be a sci-fi action film title. To be honest, this would have been great as a movie more than a video game. Now, that's not saying that it's a bad game. It's actually a pretty good game for what it is, making the decisions like the other games, but I believe they left the horror aspect when they finished the very first game, Until Dawn. It just kind of went downhill from that. To be honest, it's $30, which wasn't bad. Yeah, is it worth the money? You know, that's to be considered on who you are. So I felt like when I was playing this, I was playing a movie that should have been like a 90s, 80s feel, which is technically the time period it was set in. So that was okay. But it was kind of cliched in a lot of things that it did. Some of the dialogue, some of the action points. If you've never played any of these games, I recommend it. Because the action points means you're going to choose how these characters survive in the movie. Quote unquote, your gameplay. So technically, this entire set is a story being told by a storyteller, which actually you get to see this said storyteller. Now, technically, if the storyteller, you get the gist that he might be death itself. Whether he is or not, you'll have to find out. So there is a lot of stuff that gets told that's kind of like on the confines of, should it be known as horror in this generation? Well, this generation does a lot of downwater as stuff, and it felt PG-13, and that's how a lot of horror films these days are. But anyways, I'm digressing. It starts off really well with drawing you in with a scene showing you in the desert, old Iraq, to be honest, and it is showing you the beginnings of the story and what is getting ready to unfold and the monsters that you will have to deal with, whether it is the people itself or these hidden legendary creatures that are, you know, considered to be gods of that time or a plague of that time. And when it fast forwards itself through to a military point where you're a bunch of soldiers going on a journey to find hidden weapons. Now, this gave you the hidden weapons aspect during Iraq for a lot of other names were dropped. Some actual historical characters that was big during the 90s and up until the 2000 eras too. But again, I'm digressing from the point. So once you get to this point, you're going through, you're making all these action decisions. Your team gets, they get ambushed, whether you do it properly or you do it a different way. It gives you two choices on how to do this. Now, when it throws you into this, you know, hidden area below the sands, that's when the horror aspect starts to go again. And they're in a fight for their lives. They're trying to figure out how to get back up and get out of this. And then it becomes where you start learning about these creatures that you've seen at the very beginning. And these creatures, apparently, they start as like a disease and a parasite, but this disease and a parasite turns them into what looks like giant vampires, like actual bat-like vampires, which is really cool, because at the beginning I thought that was something called a Strigoi, which you've seen in some vampire movies. They're supposed to be a precursor to vampires and that kind of thing. But then it 180s itself. And as you're going through, it goes back to being action. And then it starts to lose its horror aspect once you find out that, hey, these guys, they're not actually vampires. They're space aliens. Oh yeah, and not the confines of space aliens, but think on the movie franchise Prometheus, the Alien series, the precursor to all that. Dude, they do the whole one aspect of where you find, spoiler, when you find these aliens in their chamber, but it's a spaceship chamber. And apparently something, some kind of black goo made them devolve into being this murderous, bloodthirsty, vampiric, parasite creature. And that's where we get that it no longer is a horror film, because it's all choice in surviving and shoot things down and blowing things up. Like, what happened to the buildup to being completely horror? Like, what happened to your monsters at the beginning running around murdering your people and then murdering the other enemy terrorists group that was trapped down there with you? What happened to the entire buildup? And it just goes out the door. So, yeah. It's not a bad game, and I'm gonna go ahead and say that. It's definitely not a bad game at all, but there's no way I can say that this game is horror. I can say that this game is action and sci-fi. And which is not bad. Like I've said a bunch of times already, it's not bad at all. And to be honest, would I play this again for the other endings? Absolutely not. Because yeah, there's already, you know, plenty of people out there who have already went through the game a million times, gave you all the endings, that kind of thing. But I felt that the choices I made is a real ending for me. And when I made my choices, just like any movie, why would I rewind the movie to hope for something better? It's just not a thing I do. Yeah, I kind of wish I know what the other endings are. And if you, by all means, play through and get all the endings, that's something you can do. But this game did take me 5.5 hours just for what I got. And then we end up getting the special ending, which is basically the military knew everything. Well, that's not the special ending, but the military knew everything. The United States government was at fault. They knew everything behind all the stuff. Okay, so that's very cliche, because anytime, any situation, apparently the United States government has always known about everything and anything, which is overused, overplayed, and overdone. The special ending was that it showed us our next game, and they call it the final chapter. And the trailer that was released recently was the same thing that you got after beating the game. So, you know, that's kind of cool. I recommend you guys looking for that trailer too. I may or may not do a review on that, but that's digressing. So yeah, this is House of Ashes. It's kind of a short review, I know. It's a little bit drawn out a bit, but to be honest, I recommend that you play the game yourself to find out what it really is about. Again, it's very beautiful. It does a wonderful aspect of grabbing your attention at the beginning, gives you your choice dialogues, but you know, at the end of the day, I can't say that it's horror at all, and that's just my decision. You may have a different decision. Please let me know. And honestly, if you, you know, if you guys want to comment more about this, then hit the comment section and I will talk more anytime. That I will try to get to all the comments as I can about it. But this is me signing off. And again, you can catch me playing this stuff on Twitch first. or sometimes I just load up demos before I do anything. But, yep, this is me signing off. You guys have a wonderful night.